Hello, my dear children. Today we are going to learn about a new chapter, that is chapter 9, Be Courteous. Children, the word courteous means being polite in our attitude and behavior towards others. That is why in order to be courteous, we should smile, say please, excuse me, hello, and I'm sorry. Also, we should always say thank you. All these are good manners when we have a courteous response to others. In the following lesson, you are going to learn about it in details. So, let's get started. So, my dear children, like I said, courtesy means being polite in our attitude and behavior towards others. It involves good manners, gentleness, kindness, and etiquettes. The words like sorry, please, thank you, excuse me, may I, pardon, and welcome, and etc. are some words of courtesy. So my dear children, whenever anybody asks you anything or speaks to you, that time we shouldn't be rude to them, right? That's why we should have a courteous response towards them. And the response can be sorry, please, thank you, excuse me, may I, pardon, and welcome. Like the 26th president of USA said, courtesy is much a mark of a gentleman as courage. It means if you have a courtesy towards other, you are considered gentleman. It is also a mark of a courage. All people cannot become a gentleman, right? So in order to become a gentleman, we should be courteous, or we should have courtesy towards others. Now, in the following story, we are going to learn an act of courtesy. So, let's see. On a hot summer day, Rohit, a 10-year-old boy, was standing in the lawn of his house. Suddenly, he saw an old man entering his lawn. As Rohit moved towards him, he noticed that the man was sweating badly and was thus looking very frustrated. So there was a boy named Rohit who was 10 years old. And when he was standing in front of his lawn, he saw a man come in. So Rohit went to the man and noticed that the man was sweating badly. And also he was looking very frustrated, and maybe he was angry too. Let us see why. After reaching near the old man, Rohit said, "Hello, uncle. How can I help you?" The old man asked, "Is it house number 41? Rohit replied, "Yes, uncle. I would like to meet Mr. Saxena," said the old man. Hearing this, Rohit said, "Uncle, though it is house number 41, it is not Mr. Saxena's residence. It is actually Mr. Pandey's residence." The old man said, "Seems that I have a wrong address," as he had turned back to go. Rohit said, "Uncle, please wait. Have a glass of water." "Yes," said the old man, thinking that he really needs a glass of water. So the old man came and said to Rohit that how can he help him. So the old man said he was looking for house number 41. And when he asked, "Is it Mr. Saxena's house?" Rohit said, "It's not Mr. Saxena's house. Instead, it is Mr. Pandey's residence or house." So the old man said that maybe he came to the wrong address. So when he was turned and wanted to go back, Rohit said, "Uncle, please wait, have a glass of water." So the old man said yes, and he was thinking maybe he'll get a glass of water. Rohit went inside and came back with a glass of water, a few biscuit and a towel. The old man ate the biscuit, drank the water and wiped his face with the towel. He thanked Rohit. Rohit replied, "Welcome, uncle," he added. "This is block number 1. You can try in block number 2. Saying this, Rohit replied and explained him the way to block number 2. After a few days, Rohit's father, Mr. Tarun Pandey, told him, "We have to vacate this house. I have come to know about a flat which we will go to see tomorrow." Next morning, Rohit and his father reached a building. Leaving Rohit in a park, Mr. Pandey went in. He returned after 10 minutes and said, "The owner wants 1 year rent in advance. I do not have so much money. We will have to look for some other property." Rohit noticed that his dad was looking quite sad. As they started to move out, they heard a voice. "Excuse me, Mr. Pandey, please wait." As Rohit looked upward towards the voice, he saw the same old man in the balcony. Soon, the old man came down. Rohit greeted him. "Hello, uncle." The old man smiled. He asked Rohit's father, "How do you know this child?" "He is my son," replied Rohit's father. Hearing this, the old man told about Rohit's courtesy to his father and said, "I am sorry to ask for a deposit. Your son was so good to me that day. It seems that your family is very courteous and caring. You can come to live in my flat and pay the rent on a monthly basis." Rohit and his father were rejoiced and said, "Thank you." So children, try to cultivate courtesy in yourselves. It is sweeten your life and also improve your relationship with others. Now, let me tell you, my dear children. When Rohit came back with the glass of water and a few biscuit in his hand, he gave it to the old man. An old man drank the water and what did he do? He wiped his face with a towel. He also thanked Rohit and Rohit replied him, "Welcome." He also suggested to look him for block number 2 instead of block number 1. That is the flats they are talking about or the neighborhood they are talking about. So, after a few days, Rohit's father told Rohit that he need to vacate. That means he need to empty the house and look for some other house. So, when they went to look for another flat, that time the owner asked for 1 year deposit money. In order to buy a house, a person needs to deposit some money. When the old man saw Rohit standing on the lawn, he asked his father, "Who is this boy?" Then his father said, "He is my son." So, hearing this, the old man said everything about the other day's courteous response of Rohit, and he replied that he doesn't have to pay the yearly bill. He just have to pay the rent on a monthly basis. So both Rohit and his father were very happy and they said, Thank you. So, from this story, what did you learn, my dear children? That we should always cultivate this courtesy in ourselves. Why? Because in order to live in a society, it helps our relationship with other friends and family, and also our neighbor and the people around us. It is good to have a courtesy in ourselves. That is why, please remember to have a courtesy in yourselves when anybody asks you anything. Now, let's see the ponder and practice. Courtesy can be expressed through word as well as by way of actions. Always be courteous towards other and develop a habit of using words of courtesy frequently. So, my dear children, what are the courteous response we should have? We should have courteous response like sorry, please, thank you, excuse me, may I, pardon and welcome. So, if you hurt anyone, you should say sorry. If you need to talk to someone, you should first say please, or if you want something, you should say please. And when the work is done, when someone helps you or do anything, what you should say? Thank you. And when you want to leave some place, what kind of thing you should say? Yes, excuse me. Or if you have to speak to someone in the middle of something, what you should say? Yes, may I. And if you couldn't hear something when a person said, what you should say? Pardon. And when someone says thank you to you, what you should say? Correct. Welcome. So, my dear children, I hope this was an interesting topic for you. Please learn some courteous manners so that it helps you in your future also. Now, I'll see you in the next class. Till then, take care and God bless you all. Bye-bye.